chapter 10 Mark chapter 10 verse 46 10:46 Yesterday I watched the television movie about food thing. It's very interesting, so I think about this. Before that, I'm going to bring the lesson from Matthew chapter 2. But this guy grabbed it. Almost the same thing. So they call the program is called the, how you say it? Blind? It's not the blind taste. So the MC of the program is totally blind. With you know, stick walking, and then with another very well known star of Thailand. So they two together. The thing is, the blind is the A, right? And this is the star. This is changing every. They go to some places. So they went to some Sukhumvit somewhere, 49 something, to the burger place, big tower burger thing. But the thing is, they fall down, they close down this star TV, and then walk with the blind. The blind lead them, and the star need to, you know, hold the big thick cloth, black cloth, and walk with them, traveling from the BTS and go to this restaurant. And it's very serious when they sit down and eat this big hamburger thing together with blind. And the star have to close all the way, right?
Blindfold.
Yeah, blindfold and eat and touch it and smell it. The thing that he said, I never recognize it is so hard. It is so tough. It's nothing that you think I do it for the TV show, right? And I think, man, it will be very easy. But he said, I don't know how to grab the fork, the spoon, pick the thing. And he asked, do you know what this is? He said, can I touch it? Can I smell it? Can I do a lot of things just to touch? And then if he can describe the food correctly, what kind of food, everything, that's a TV show. It told me that sometime when we're not in the same shoes, same situation, we're not going to know it. We're not going to feel it. And then when I went to Atlanta last 2 years, that's an exhibition. I don't know what they call it, but they close down the hall so dark, and they bring all the blind come to us. And then we have one stick, and we have to blind ourselves. And then he said, we will teach you how to live one life if you are blind. So I remember that. Because he said, they put a place like a supermarket and said, okay, let's go shopping. And he teaches how to know the apple, the orange, how to know the number, how to listen to the voice. So we'll talk about this thing in the book of Mark chapter 10, 46. Then they came to Jericho as Jesus and his disciples. Together with a large crowd were leaving the city, a blind man, Bartimaeus, which means son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside begging. So the story happened that in the Jews, when you cannot see or you blind or do something, it's very hard to earn your life. So he just like a baker on the street, right? On the midst of the street. And then what happened is he was sitting by the roadside baking when he heard that it was Jesus. So what is his sense of knowing Jesus is coming?
He heard.
Only heard, right?
Yeah.
How he sensed Jesus with his voice. Ears, right? So it's something totally different. When we went to ACU, and when I go there, they said, rally, when he introduced me to one of professor, he said, if you see my glass is this big, this thick, 3,000 my glass, so big that when I wear it, it's just destroy my nose. It's very big, thick, 3,500. I am maybe the first student in all in entire Thailand who wear first contact lens because it's so thick like this. And everyone know me because they call me Ai Wen. Ai Wen, because my glass is so thick, very thick. And then when I bring it out, it's just blurring. I cannot see anything. But this is totally blind. Remember that that professor said, the doctor said he will lose his sight in pretty soon. And I said, how do you read the Bible? So Larry and the professor took me to his desk. He got this big thing, big Bible with braille thing. He said right now he practicing to read the Bible in braille. He's a professor, he's a doctor, very old, almost lost his sight. But to us, if we lose the sight, we said, okay, that's it. God, we don't care about this. But the guy, that old professor, starting what? Practicing his new kind of sense, reading by braille, touching. So this is very important. When God give us all this seeing thing, this tasting, this hearing, this, you know, tasting with our, so we don't know what happened. But this guy heard Jesus. What do you think? Said the Bible said, when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout, Jesus, son of David, what? Have mercy. Mercy on me. You know what the word Bartimaeus mean? He said, which means the son of Bartimaeus. Bartimaeus is honor. in another language, high ranking, everything is high, but to him, what is going on? Not see TV in my class.
It's the Bible.
Oh, it's a Bible. I'm sorry. that's a guy doing. They cannot read. They open that Bible and then it's a sound come up. But you know what? When every night, when we do a lot of things and we do a lot of things and then we cannot sleep, I said to my wife, hey, let's do something like this. Open this app and open the Bible. About 10 minutes, what's going on? The sound is perfect. Another 10 minutes, what's going on? Our battery run out because we sleep. Don't do it. Okay. He began to shout, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Let's turn to the Matthew chapter 9. Matthew chapter 9, verse 27. 9:27. As Jesus went out from there, two blind men followed him, calling out, "Have mercy on us, son of David." So a lot of
people in that time, you know, always ask Jesus for something. You as a foreigner, maybe sometime you've been asking all around. Can I have something? Remember when in Acts, when Peter and another one walked on the temple, they said, can I have something? And then what did Peter say? We have nothing, only we have is the name of Jesus, right? So always remember, this is a time that
the son of the owner asked the son of the carpenter, have mercy on me. Okay, 48. Many rebuked him and told him to be quiet.
But he shout all the more, Son of David, have mercy on me.
So, what happened? Did he ask for healing? Yes, maybe. But what did he say? Have mercy on me. And people tried to what? Stop him. And then what did he do? More louder. Why? I just curious. I just question myself why.
He wants
to be
heard. Huh? Want to be heard.
Do you want to be heard?
It reminds me of a little kid. Like, yeah. Church, if you're like, be quiet, then they get louder.
Okay, what else? What else? What do you think?
Priorities in order.
Huh?
He has set his priorities in the right order.
Yeah. So just look like to me that his one goal is what? Jesus, I don't care about any people try to stop me. I don't care that people try to what? Rebuke me. And sometimes, even though the time, they this is a good word, they will do anything to save them, lose face. The time. They will get big ceremony, marry, a lot of money spent on that thing. They want to be high. And after 2 months, they break up. That's okay. But they want to save face all the time. So if you do, some people it's very, very dangerous. They'll remember it for long, you know. Sometimes, you know, they try to compromise a lot of things, right, going on. But if people just like you walk sometime and then say, hey, you don't zip your pants real good in front of people, and they just left. And I remember one time people parked something not good place, and someone said, hey, you need to park real good in front of people. The guy left, drive away, never came back. Nothing. But totally, Bartimaeus, what happened to him? He don't care. On his focus is what?
Want to be
heard by Jesus.
So people rebuked him, and people said a lot of things, and many rebuked him and told him to be quiet. But he shouted all the more, Son of David, have mercy on me. 49.
Jesus stopped and said, call him. What happened? Maybe Jesus walked with a lot too many crowds, right? Many people want him to do this, to that. Maybe he will pass away. Maybe sometime, maybe he don't see it. But the guy, because maybe the blind is very, you know, in second place, you know, disadvantage, cannot do anything. All he have is his voice. Somebody rebuke him. Stop. Don't. Quiet. And the guy said, Jesus, Jesus. More. What happened to that? Yeah, and then what happened? And Jesus said what? Hey. I heard something. This guy's voice is so strong to the Lord's ear. Did he see him?
No.
What? Only what? Another sense of touching, right? What?
Hearing.
The guys cannot see. Jesus, maybe too many crowd, too many people. But to me, the priority, the number one point is just to ask. And then I told you in the story Wednesday night, the guy who go to China, remember that? He said he from that church, big one, saddleback thing with that Rick Warren thing, right? He said he'll go to China and he will go in the time of Christmas, and he would maybe, if they invite him to speak, he would speak about Christmas, seeing how you worship God, how everything. So he go early, 1 hour early.
9 o'clock, he go 8 o'clock just because maybe he doesn't know the place. He want to investigate. He want to take picture.
He said,
inside of the church before things happen with door open, about 300-400 Christian China come together in the whole place of December in China. They start singing and they start to, you know, just try to focus.
First priority, just ask God to hear their voice. And the guy said, I'm stern. I'm done. I think I'm gonna go teach, you know. When we go outside up country, right? And when we go to Chaiyaphum, we go to Phetchabun, we think, hey, we from Bangkok, we're gonna teach them. We go there, they give us the best place in their home. I said, what is that? They said, the chicken. I said, what's going on with that? They said, they've been feeding this for a lot of months. They don't do it. They don't kill it. We only visitor. I said, what? And the group gonna come from Atlanta. We work over the church in Chiang Mai. They told me once, every year they send a team to Africa from the big homeland, big house, United States, big car, big everything. They went to Africa. They said, the people there, the Christian, invite them to the shack in the house there. And they said, every people that live in the shack, very small room, go outside and let the guests go sleep in the floor and everything. They said, man, when they go back to the big homeland, big scooter, big too many cars, they said, wow. It totally changed their life. They're going back there and said, man, you guys totally more than you can imagine. God has blessed you. We've been there. We live in the shack, in the tree, and it's nothing. So talk to this. This guy got nothing. No sight. Cannot see it. I don't know what happened. But you think about the pink taxi there. You can see it very what? Very pink, right? Yesterday I went to the mall and I told my wife, I really like that shoe. It's real bright yellow thing. The shoe, very yellow. I want to have that. But my wife said, well, you better take care. You better look very carefully because right now all Thai people, they wear yellow to what? To pay respect to the king, right? And then if the preacher wear the yellow to all around to the to the airport, what happened? They think maybe you disgrace the king with the shoes, right? For me, I don't think about that at all. I said, yeah, maybe true, maybe true. Maybe you're right. Hey, that's yellow thing. That's something like that. But to this guy, he shout out loud. He do whatever he can just to pay attention to God. When we pray, when we, you know, worship, when we do things, we do something like this. Remember the story that filthy rich come to the temple and then he poured a big money on the table. And then what? The widow come up with many fields to live on. The Bible said to live on. If she give this field, 10, I don't know how to say in English, she got nothing. And Jesus said, all these rich people, they come back with money, with coin, just to put on the temple table with sound. They said, man, it will hear. People will hear that. Oh, this brother L. Oh, man. But this widow come up with so few to live on. But Jesus, attention on this thing. Because he lived this, he got two more in the Kasikorn Bank, in Thai Farmer Bank, in Bangkok Bank.
he got some more.
But this widow, if she keep this, what happened?
Nothing.
She only have her life and
God's hand.
No more. Only live with God. No more. No more thing to depend on. The guy said, hey, you better stop. We rebuke you. But this Bartimaeus said, no way. I'm not going to stop. I'm not going to cry now to God. I will ask God for mercy. I will bring God attention. And sometimes we, how you say, when we see these Islam people, what did they do? They say five things, two hands, knees, and four to what?
Touch the ground.
How many times in one day?
Five times.
Five times. And we think, man, this guy is very religious, right? Talking about us. How about us?
We do that more? We pray five times long?
No. Why? We ask for more accident, loss of love, or some hard, dangerous business going crash down. But in normal days, hey, God, you live away. I'm walk this street. But when I need you, I call you, God. Right? This guy said, I will not stop. Okay, let's read some more and then we're done. Jesus stopped and said, call him. So they called to blind man. Cheer up on your feet. He's calling you. I don't know what happened. Maybe these people never see this blind before. But when Jesus said, call him, this guy said, oh, come on, cheer up right now. Totally what? Yeah, opposite change. Maybe just like us, right? Maybe we are one of disciples. We don't care about people until God can say, okay, if God care, what happened to us? We need to do it sometime, right? Okay, so throwing his cloak aside, he jumped to his feet and came to Jesus. Oh, this is very important, cloak. Only one piece of clothes that the baker have. Food prevent from cold. Maybe some coin that he have. Everything that he have is a cloak. It's everything. Cloak sometimes refer to your honor, yourself, your things that you prevent your from, right? Your suit, your thing that you have. He said he just throw that thing down and do what? Jump on his feet and do what? And 51, what do you want me to do for you? Jesus asked him. That is so another strange. Because Jesus don't know that this guy want to have sight. Why he asked? You want to have, what do you want me to do? He don't say, okay, Jesus, I throw my cloak. Why don't you go laundry my cloak? Sometimes God asks us something just to do what? To pay attention. What do you really want to do with your life? What is your priority? What is your first and foremost? What is your thing? What is your attention right now? And then the blind man called, Rabbi, I want to see. Very cut, very clear. I want to see.
Mark chapter 10, verse 36.
Uh-huh.
He answered that question for two of the disciples.
Right, because the disciples asked what?
They asked for the honor.
Yeah, right.
And they're asking, so Jesus asked, he says, well, what do you want me to do for you?
Okay.
And he said, give us the
right, right.
Honor.
Yeah, that's a point too.
Yeah, and then the next story is blind man Bartimaeus.
Yeah.
What do you want me to do? He says, let me see.
Right, exactly.
Right,
it come together.
The people who are right there next to them.
Uh-huh.
Just like we seem to, we want to live right there next to Christ.
Right.
We expect, but sometimes they don't see
them. Yeah. You if you read the story of the gospel, sometime one story, Jesus asks something, and then another story, he will answer the same story up there. Sometimes the disciple asks something, who
who is my master?
And then some demon said, he's the son of God. He's a Messiah, something like that. That right.
Well, that, and then Mark happens in chapter 8 as well, where he heals a blind man, but the blind man can't really see clearly.
Yeah.
So he has to heal him again.
Yeah.
And then right after that is Peter's confession of who Jesus is.
All right.
Right. So, and here, then the blind man has this confession of who Jesus is,
mm-hmm.
and he can see clearly.
Okay.
So
okay.
It's all connected.
Thank you. That's a good thing. I like that. 52. Go, say Jesus, your faith has healed you. Immediately, he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. What does that mean? The yellow flower that maybe is too many years that he didn't see. The Bible said he completely see the sight. Very yellow, very brown, everything cut clear, very. I remember when I put another lens in my this one I wear contact lens, right? This one when I send my daughter to some examination 4 or 5 years ago, I talked to my wife, said, why there's a me on over there. I tried it. No, it's in here. And my wife said something wrong, you must go to see eye doctor. And they said when you owe to that age, they got cataract. So I got to, and then when the, how you say it, they put some really sharp knife. I said, please stop. He said, the doctor said, what happened? I cannot do it. 4th, 5th time. Okay, ready? Put. I said, please, let me pray. I cannot do it. The doctor, the woman said, hey, you see that table near you, the 5-year-old kid, the girl, she go in the first one. You better stop whining, you better stop crying. Just do it. Okay. But when I finish this thing, I come out, I told my wife, man, I don't wear my contact lens, this one, but it's what very, very, very clear. Cut clear, very nice one to see things without no contact lens. When I wake up in the morning, the next day, after they put this for 7 days, they bring it out. I said, honey, I never saw you this pretty before. Because it's so clear. It's so clear, right? Same thing. We see things in wrong pattern for many times. This guy received his sight. And then it's become so real, so true, so clear. He see things, and maybe the disciples see more things clear. Jesus gave his sign and he said, go, because your faith has healed you. What is his faith? He asking. He's never stopped. Nobody can stop him. He will cry out more. He will ask God. He will say, I'm not going to give up. I'm going to call more. I'm going to call out loud. I'm not going to, anybody will say me, I'm loose face. I'm fine. I'm going. Big thing for the Thai people. If you in the community of Thai people, in the Buddha face, in the Buddhist face, if you become, you got 5 in your people, right? And then one of you become a Christian. One big thing. These 4 will lose their faith to the people of Buddhism community. And they said, what is your son going on? Did he crazy? He believe in Christianity and everything. And they're not gonna speak to them. It's just something like that. They call the boycott team or whatever. And when one of the Christians see this, well, they disgrace their family. Sometimes they throwing back, put on their clothes, going back and blind again. Going back to the Buddhism. It's hard to leave things. It's hard to stay focused. It's hard to go on the road and ask for Jesus. All this thing happened many, many times. A lot of people in very big society, in company, in every high ranking,
that is probably in my Thai family. Things are very friction. And I didn't realize what it was till you just pointed it out. Now I realize it's
going on. Right. It is. It is. You will feel like you are an alien. You will see like you are mad. And you follow Jesus in this society, you are something that. So you don't know when some Thai come from a Christian, I mean Buddhist background, and they said, I follow Jesus. Too many things after that. And we growing up in Christian family, it's very easy, just like that, right? Remember this. He throw his cloak, he shout out loud, he don't care, he just want God to see his intention. Okay, so I want to speak on Matthew chapter 2, so this is so new to me, so I'm sorry that the preacher